We got a gas-fired slump chamber in front here, an electric annealing section in back. We're introducing the gas into this mobile firebox. It comes around up here, slumps the sheet. We're operating at about 1230 up here, 1230 Fahrenheit. You can see it's red heat, well above 1100 degrees. We've got some shaft cooling devices here to keep the bearings cool and to keep the center drum from slumping. The apparatus for introducing the gas to the firebox. In this wire way, we've got all the thermocouples coming. We've got thermocouples every 4 feet going down this machine, top and bottom of the belt, each side. We flew the gases off through these two flues, up and out. At this point, we're into the electric annealing section. Inside these chambers, we've got nichrome wire heating elements, which you can see through there. Initially, just to bring the chambers up, but after that point, we're in a controlled cooling situation where we're actually flowing heat off here, bringing in ambient air through the center, circulating it around with a stainless steel fan. Buffer zones between each one of these. Again, thermocouples every 4 feet, top and bottom of the belt. Third and last recirculating chamber. By this point, we're below the strain point of the glass, and it's strictly cooling down to room temperature. Got the electric control panel here, controls the heating elements, when they're on and off, and the fans, which are actually, the controlling's done by these controlling instruments with a set point for whatever temperature we want in any chamber, adjusted to it, and it'll control it to that temperature. And we can get any annealing curve we need for the specific glass. This is a cadmium yellow and chrome aventurine green. The tips and tails of these sheets are kept crushed up in this barrel and recycled. We recycle our own in-house cullet. By recycling our own cullet, we can get a batch remelted and ready to cast in probably about 3 hours as opposed to 8 to 10, sometimes 12 hours in the original melt.
It costs us less to melt it, and it makes beautiful glass. It's called curious glass. The glass we make out of this is different than any other glass because it's a mix. We have two glasses mixed together. They've already been melted. We've already put all that energy into it. Now we're going to add a little bit more energy, and we're going to get twice as much out of it. Different color. We couldn't do it any other way. Remelting is the only way we can get this color.
Through keeping some empirical data on doing this, we've got pretty good. We can actually produce sample color every once in a while by doing it.
We have a set of samples that we match. And in order to match those samples, the glasses are so sensitive that as furnaces change, as sources of raw materials change, and many other changes that take place, the thickness of the sheet, the way it's being annealed, there's actually a fair amount of experimentation required to do something exactly the same. Formula. Formulas alter, I've got a record of every formula we've ever melted. I've got a record of every glass we've ever melted.
Thank you.
grow in size. We do not care to become so large that we lose the personal touch. Right now, we have 18 employees, and because there's three of us, it's like a 6-to-1 ratio. There's six people every one of us, and that's pretty personal. That's better than even a good graduate program. You know, we're about 30-to-1, 20-to-1, so that we can keep a good touch. The way we want to grow is to grow in quality, and by quality I mean getting into producing glasses that nobody in the world can produce because they don't have that intimacy of the people that close to the glass. So what we want to do is grow financially, yes, but grow not through producing more of the same, but producing products that haven't been produced, real specialty glasses.